Tonight, we're going to start with the plenary, where I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the academic and the professional life in the UK. Basically, my whole journey to Britain dates back 20 years ago. And in 1997, I went there for the first time, where I took an English course in a school called Euro Center in Lee Green. It's located near Greenwich. And it was basically an English course that we do like summer courses, and they would grant you, you would be given an English certificate. Then in 1999, I went back to the UK to do the academic study there. That's when I went to take an undergraduate course. This is a little bit about how you can enter a British university. Basically, we've got an UCAS form. In England, they don't have a vestibular. So instead of that, what we do, we have this form. You choose up to 60 universities, and you have to include your school report, which in Brazil is our bulletin, and you also write a reference letter. Actually, it's your teacher and director that writes the reference letter. And you have to do a personal statement about yourself as a student, as a person. And you were given back, you know, from the 60 universities, you were given a conditional offer or unconditional offer. Conditional is if there is a condition that you do something, have a better grade in English or a portfolio or something like that. Or unconditional, it's just like, please come in, basically. I did a BSc. We've got in here two types in Britain. We've got the BA and the BSc. In Brazil, everything is BA. BA is when you have just one area of study. So, for example, you could have a BA in medicine. Now, a BSc is a combination of degrees. It's when you have like a combination of areas. You could have something like... which was my case. I had a combination of cultural studies and mass communications. But you can mix different areas as long as they approve the form. So the university I went to was called the University of North London. I went there in 1999. This university got merged with London Guildhall in 2002. And then they became the London Metropolitan University. And this was called... afterwards, it was called the North Campus, and Guildhall was called the City Campus. There are two buildings here. I don't know if you can see, but the taller one, the highest one, is called the Tower Building, and this white one, written in University of North London, is called Tech Tower. The Tower Building was focused more like in the management area and language area. It's what they called like faculty of language. So I did French there, psychology, and in the Tech Tower you would basically do your assignments and your studies. It's basically each floor has loads and loads of computers. You could just choose one of them and study there. Now this one is just opposite. This area is called Holloway Road. That's in North London, Zone 2. And this building is called the Learning Center. The Learning Center is basically a library where you study. You've got two floors. And back in those days, it was more books, like the real ones. Nowadays, everything is more digital. And this was the main faculty for my degree, which was Ladbroke House. Ladbroke House is opposite Highbury Park, which I'm going to show you further. Pretty much what I did that was this combination of cultural studies and mass communications. Cultural studies, I studied more identity, ideologies. You've got like masculinity, feminism, subcultures, a range of subcultures. And mass communications is more focused like on TV, internet, cinema, fashion, and advertising.